again I'm with you with the concept that is right circular cone, curved surface area and total surface area of cylinder. Okay. So first problem is the circumference of the base of 10 meter high conical tent is 44 meter. Okay, what is given? Circumference is given, circumference of the base of 10 meter high conical tent, means this is the height, 10 meter is the height of the cone, is 44 meter, circumference is 44 meter and height is 10 meter. Calculate the length of canvas used in making the tent if width of canvas is 2 meter. Width is given and we have to find out length of the canvas. Okay, so to find out this we need to use circumference. So first I'm taking here circumference is given 44 meters, circumference is given 44 meter, and what is given? Height is given, height is equals to 10 meter. These two things are given, and one more thing is given, width of canvas is given, width of canvas is given 2 meters, width of canvas is given 2 meters. Okay, so now first we will use circumference. Okay, now circumference of the base, circumference we denote by 2 pi r, circumference is equal to the perimeter of circle. Okay, so that we denote by 2 pi r, so that here I am taking that is 2 pi r is equal to 44. Okay, so now with the help of this we will get radius. Okay, here we can put 2 multiply by 22/7 multiply by radius is unknown is equal to 44. Okay, so now radius is equal to 44 multiply by 22 are 44 divided by 7, so we can take reciprocal of that, that is 7/44. So radius is equal to 44 and 44 will be cancelled, 7 centimeters. So we got here 7 centimeters. Why we are finding radius? Because see, canvas used in making, so we need to find out curved surface area, because it will be open from the downside, cone will be open, tent will be open from the bottom. Okay, so here we are finding curved surface area. Okay, so to find out curved surface area we are going to use formula pi r l. Okay, so we must know radius and height. Okay, so now here height is given 10 meters, height is given 10 meters. So with the help of radius and height we have to find out slant height. Okay, so L we are going to find out. So L is equal to what? L equals to under root H square plus R square, H square plus R square. H is given 10 square plus R is 7 centimeters, so 7 square. So 10 square is 100 plus 7 square is 49. So it will be 149. It will be 149. But 149 is not a perfect square. So we need to find out square root of root 149. Understood? So this square root we can find out easily by division method. Okay. So that I am showing here in short, that is 149. Is not a perfect square, so we are going to take decimal points. Okay, so we are going to make here groups, so this in first 49 and there will be one digit in first group and this will be in one group. Okay, so first we are going to think about one, so here will be one square is one, so 1 - 1 will be 0. Now I am taking this whole pair downside 49. Okay, so I am going to add the same number, 1 + 1 is here, it will come 2. Okay, so 49 is there, I need to put here such a number whose product will come equal to this or smaller than this. So I am taking that 22 2's are 44. Okay, so 49 - 44 will be 5. Okay, so here I am going to add the same number, 22 + 2 is 24. Okay, so now here this whole group will come here and decimal point will shift here. Okay, so 500 is there, so 241, 1 we cannot take, 2 we will take, then it will be satisfied. So I am taking here 2. Okay, 242 2's are 484 and it will be 16. Okay, but here we got 12.2 and you will get something, but this is enough. Okay, so square root of root 149 we will use 12.2. Okay, so this way we have to find out square root with when it is not a perfect square. So that I am taking here 12.2. Slant height we got 12.2. Okay, so now we have L also, we have R also. So now we have to find out curved surface area. Okay, why we are finding curved surface area? Because here they are asking calculate the length of canvas used in making the tent. Okay, so curved surface area we will find out and then we will think about length. Okay, so CSA curved surface area of tent is equals to pi r l. Okay, so that will be 22 upon 7 multiplied by radius we have 7 multiplied by this slant height is 12.2 centimeter square. Okay, so now here we can cancel 7 we can cancel, 22 2s are 44. Okay, so this product you will get 268.4 centimeter square. Okay, so we have now curved surface area. This product 22 multiplied by 12.2 you will get 268.4 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the curved surface area, but this is not our final answer. Our actual question is different. What they are asking, calculate the length. Calculate the length. Okay, if you see that canvas width is given, canvas will be like this, canvas will be like this, understood? The width is given, this is given, this is given 2 meters, this is given 2 meters, understood? So now here all the dimensions are given, centimeter is not there, meter is given, so meter square. Okay, so now this is also in meter, so 268.4 meter square. Okay, and this is given in 2 meter and we have to find out length of this. We have to find out the length of this. This is unknown. We have to find out length. Okay, so length into breadth is equal to area is going to come. So that only we are going to use, length into width is equal to area. Okay, so length is unknown, so that length multiplied by width is 2 meter is equal to area is 268.4 meter square. So length is equal to what? 268.4 divided by 2 meters. Okay, meter square divided by 2 meter, it will be 134.2 meters. So length will be 134.2 meters. Understood? So what was the question C? In question they are asking the length of canvas used in making the tent of width 2 meters. Okay, first circumference was given. With the help of circumference we have to find out radius, because without radius we cannot find out curved surface area. So with the help of this radius and height we have to find out slant height, because slant height and radius is important to find out curved surface area or total surface area. Okay, so here in curved surface area when you will put the values, that time you will get 268.4 meter square. Okay, width was given, width is given, so we have to put length multiplied by width is equal to area. So area, curved surface area here we are going to use. So length is equal to 134.2 meter. Okay, so this is our final answer. Okay. Here, our next problem is, a tent is of the shape of right circular cylinder up to a height of 3 meters and then becomes a right circular cone with a maximum height of 13.5 meters above the ground. Calculate the cost of painting the inner side of the tent at the rate of rupees 2 per square meter if the radius of the base is 14 meters. Okay, so what is given here? Radius is given, radius of the base is given 14 meters. This is one thing is given. Okay, one more thing is given here. See, a rate is given rupees 2 per square meters, that we will think afterwards. Okay, so once again I am going to read your problem and we will try to take your figure. Okay, so we will try to construct figure. A tent is of the shape of right circular cylinder up to a height of 3 meters. So there is a right circular cylinder. Tent is in the shape of right circular cylinder up to a height of 3 meters. The height of this cylindrical tent is 3 meters. Okay. And what happens afterwards? See. And then becomes a right circular cone with a maximum height of 13.5 meters. Then it becomes a right circular cone. So on this, on the top of this cylinder, there is a right circular cone. Okay, so its maximum height is 13.5, or maximum height is 13.5. So this whole height above the ground, this is grounding level, and this maximum height is 13.5 meters. Okay, so here one thing you will understand from the figure, height of the cylinder is given. Height of the cylinder is given and whole height of this tent is given. Okay, so from this easily we can find out height of the cone. Okay, so see, first I am going to write here, let R be the radius of cylinder and H be the height of cylinder. Okay, H be the height of cylinder, small r and small h we are going to use for this. Okay, so small r, radius is given, r is equals to 3 meters, that is given directly. Height of the cylinder is given 3 meters, and what is given, height is 3 meters, h is equals to 3 meters. Okay, and radius is given 14 meters, radius r is equals to 14 meters, so 14 meters, radius is 14 meters, height is 3 meters. Okay, so radius of this is 14 meters. So obviously radius of cylinder and radius of cone will be same, because this cone is on the top of cylinder. So definitely its radius is also same, 14 meters. So we have to consider same radius for both the cone and cylinder. Okay, so radius is 14 meters. Okay, now with a maximum height of 13.5 meters, 13.5 meters is the maximum height. So we can find out height of cone is equals to what? Height of the maximum height minus height of the cylinder. Maximum height minus height of cylinder. Okay, so maximum height is, what is maximum height? 13.5 meters minus 3 meters, and height of the cylinder is 3 meters. So you will get here 13.5 minus 3 will be 10.5 meters. So this is the height of the cylinder. Okay, so from this given information, we have height of cylinder, radius of cylinder and cone 14 meters, and height of cone is 10.5 meters, means both the heights are knowing. Okay, and the question is, calculate the cost of painting the inner side of the tent, okay, at the rate of rupees 2 per square meter. Rate is given, but we need to think about what actually we have to find out. Okay, so see, once again question, calculate the cost of painting the inner side of the tent. Inner side of the tent means what? We have to find out curved surface area of cylinder as well as curved surface area of cone. Okay, so first we will find out curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. Okay, we need to do sum of both the curved surface areas, and then finally we will multiply by 2. So rate is given 2 rupees per square meter. Okay, so first, how to find out curved surface area of cylinder, that we have seen. Okay, so curved surface area of cylinder is equal to 2 pi rh. Okay, that is the formula. But curved surface area of cone is pi rl. Okay, pi rl, l we don't have, so first we need to find out l, to find out curved surface area of cone. Okay, so initially we will find out curved surface area of cylinder. Okay, so CSA, curved surface area of cylindrical tent, cylindrical part also we can say. Okay, curved surface area is equal to 2 pi rh. Okay, so 2 pi rh we will put here value, 2 multiplied by pi is 22/7, multiply by radius is 14, multiply by height of the cylinder we have to consider. Okay, height of the cylinder is 3 meters, so that I am taking here 3 into meter square. Okay, because area is there. So now here we can take 2, 7 to the 14, Okay, so here what we will get, 22 twos are 44 multiplied by 3 twos are 6 meter square. So here you will get 264 meter square is the curved surface area of cylinder. Curved surface area of cylinder. Okay, now our second task is we have to find out curved surface area of cone. Curved surface area of cone. Okay, so CSA of cone is pi RL. So slant height, L means what? Slant height. So slant height we need to find out first. Okay, so L is equals to what? L is equals to under root h square plus r square. Okay, so h is height of the cone. Here we have to consider height of the cone. So height of the cone is equals to 10.5 meters. So that I am taking here 10.5 meters square plus radius. Radius is same for both. So 14 square. Okay, so 10.5 square we need to find out. Okay, so 10.5 multiplied by 10.5 you will get the square. So that is the 110.25 plus 14 square is 196. Okay, so finally we will get the sum of these two is 306.25. Okay, and 306.25 is the perfect square. Okay, it is the perfect square. You can find out its square root. So you will get square root 17.5. So slant height we have 17.5. Okay, so we got slant height. Now easily we can find out curved surface area of the cone. Okay, so curved surface area of the cone is equals to CSA, curved surface area of cone is equals to pi RL is equals to 22/7. Pi is 22/7 multiplied by radius is 14 multiplied by length is 17.5. So that we will put here into meter square. It will come in meter square. Okay, so now here also we can do 7 twos are 14. So this product 22 twos are 44 multiplied by 17.5 meter square. So it will be 770 meter square. 770 meter square. Okay, so now both the curved surface areas we have curved surface area of cylinder also, and we have curved surface area of cone also. Okay, now question is, calculate the cost of painting the inner side of the tent. So we are finding here curved surface area. Okay, so now both the curved surface area we have, so we will find out total area of painting. Total area of painting is equals to what? CSA of cone plus CSA of cylinder. Okay, so CSA of cone is equals to 770 and 264. 770 meter square plus 264 meter square. So that final answer is 1034 meter square is the total area to be painted. Okay, total area to be painted is this. Okay, now we have to find out rate also. Rate is given rupees 2 per square meter, and this is in meter square. Okay, so directly we need to multiply. So total cost is equals to 1034 multiplied by rupees 2. So that will be 2068 rupees. Rupees 2068. So that is our final answer. Okay, so once again we will put a glance here. Question was given, a tent is of the shape of a right circular cylinder up to a height. Okay, means base was cylindrical whose height is 3 meters and then becomes a right circular cone. Okay, with a maximum height of 13.5 meters. Maximum height was given and height of cylinder was given. So with the help of these two we can find out height of the cone. Okay, so this we have to find out. Okay, radius is given, which is same for both cone and cylinder. Height is 3 meters. Whose height it is? It is the height of cylinder. Okay, so now we have to find out curved surface area, because inside, what is the question? See, calculate the cost of painting the inner side. Inner side means we have to find out curved surface area of cylinder and cone. So here we are finding curved surface area of cylindrical part, that is 2 pi r h. So we got here 264 meter square. Then we have to find out curved surface area of cone. Its formula is pi rl, but length slant height is was not given, so we have to find out slant height also. So slant height we got 17.5. So with the help of this we have to find out curved surface area of cone. So curved surface area of cone is 770 meter square. So finally we have to do addition of both the curved surface areas. So we have done that is 1034 meter square, and we have to find out total costing. So it is given rupees 2 per meter, so we have multiplied by rupees 2, so we got here rupees 2068. We denote by small r, that is given 7 meter, and height is given. Height is here vertical height, h is equal to 24 meters. Vertical height is given. Okay, slant height and vertical height, it is different. Okay, that we have seen. How many meters of cloth 5 meter wide, okay, means width is given 5 meter, will be required to make a conical tent, the radius of whose base is 7 meter and height is 24 meter. So first here we need to decide what actually we have to find out. Okay, in this case we have to find out curved surface area, because tent, okay, conical tent we have to do here. So we need to find out curved surface area of cone, because conical is given, so that we are going to use. To find out curved surface area of cone we have to use formula pi rl. Okay, but here we don't have radius, we have l, we don't have slant height, we don't have. So first we have to find out slant height. Without that we cannot find out curved surface area. Okay, so first we will find out l is equals to under root h square plus r square. Okay, so h is given directly, so that I am taking here 24 square plus radius is 7 square. So 24 square is 576 plus 7 square is 49. Okay, so addition is 625, and 625 is the perfect square. So 25 meters, slant height is 25 meters. Slant height also we have now. Okay, so slant height we have, radius we have, we can easily find out curved surface area. So CSA, curved surface area of cone, is equals to pi rl. Curved surface area of cone is equals to pi rl. So that is 22/7 multiply by radius we have, that is 7, multiply by l is 25. Okay, that is meter square. So now here 7 will be cancelled, 22 multiply by 25. Okay, so it will be 550 meter square. So we have curved surface area also. Okay, so now you know that length we have to find out. Length into width is equal to area. That area we have, width we have. So easily we can find out length. So length is equal to area divided by width. Okay, so area is 550 meter square divided by width is given 5 meters. So here we can take 5 meters. This meter will be cancelled. So 110 meters length is required. Okay, very simple example. See here once again, how many meters of cloth 5 meter wide will be required to make a conical tent, the radius of whose base is 7 meter and whose height is 24 meter. Okay, so here first we need to understand what actually we have to find out. So according to that we can decide our flow. Okay, so here radius given, height was given. So we have decided that here we have to find out curved surface area. To find out curved surface area we must know slant height. To find out slant height we can use here radius and height, vertical height. So with the help of that slant height you will get. Okay, and curved surface area now we can find out. So when you will put the values you will get 550 meter square, area you will get. Now length into width is equal to area, so area divided by width is equal to length. So that value is when